This can of Coke costs $30,000. This pack of Reese's Pieces costs $1 million. And this bottle of Heineken cost around $45 million. But why are these products so expensive? Well, it's not due to them being famous for being on a movie set. Instead, it's due to them being product placements. If you look closely at nearly any TV show that doesn't take place in medieval times, you'll find a lot of different brands. And a lot of the times, these aren't put in a TV show or movie for free. Nor do TV shows have to pay companies to allow them to use their products. In fact, it's usually the opposite, with companies paying productions for characters in a movie or TV show to use their product. And product placement is a form of advertising that actually works for both the companies and the studios making movies. It started to pick up some serious steam after the Great Depression. Ticket sales were down and Hollywood needed to figure out a way to make up for their lost revenue. So they turned to car companies to put their cars in films, and maybe even have a character mention it in the script. At first glance, product placements like this might be worrisome for the studios involved. After all, you're allowing corporations to pay for your movie, which might allow them to have some sort of influence. But in fact, it may be actually for the benefit of the movie. For example, if a character pulls up in an expensive car, the audience automatically assumes that that person is wealthy or powerful, and it automatically and easily sets up the character. And this gets even better knowing that the studio was most likely paid to put that specific car in, helping the movie get made. But product placement significantly impacts how television and movies get made. In fact, it was responsible for making the TV series Love Boat, which ran for nearly 250 episodes. Without a cruise line fully featured in the actual series, it may have never been able to get made. But product placement actually has more influence over customers than people who make the movies. Don't believe me? Well, take E.T. for example. In the 1980s, while E.T. was still in development, Universal promised Hershey that their candy would be an important part of the story. The candy company got excited about this idea and gave the studio $1 million for the promotion within the film. And after this iconic scene of E.T. and Elliot sharing some Reese's Pieces, sales for the candy skyrocketed by 70%. What was once a lesser-known candy became a staple for kids all across North America. And that was arguably the first product placement that showed just simply having your product in the movie can vastly change sales. A simple product placement can even save entire companies. Take Ray-Ban for example. The sunglasses known as Wayfarers might be seen everywhere today, but in the 1980s, they were a completely dead sunglasses fad. That was until 1983, when Tom Cruise can be seen wearing them in Risky Business. Sales jumped significantly. The company went from just a couple thousand pairs of sunglasses sold every year to millions. And now, Ray-Ban puts their sunglasses in hundreds of movies and TV shows every year. So product placement definitely works, but how much are companies willing to pay for it? Well, that depends on the studio and the project. After E.T., 20th Century Fox took note and offered companies a fee of anywhere from $10,000 to $50,000 for their product to appear in their movies. Disney product placements, on the other hand, are a bit more specific. They charge $20,000 for a visual placement, $40,000 for a brand name to be mentioned, and $60,000 if a character uses the product in the scene. And these numbers may not seem like a lot when it comes to movie budgets, but they can definitely add up. Smurfs 2, for example, had a $105 million budget, but managed to earn $150 million just from product placement alone. And the king of all product placements would have to be the Bond films. In 2012 Skyfall, Heineken paid $45 million just for Bond to drink a beer rather than his signature martini. So why are companies paying so much just to get their product seen in a movie? Well, it's definitely cheaper compared to full-on commercials, and it obviously works based off of sales. And this is in due part due to us having our guards down when we see a product in a movie. We're not recognizing it as an actual ad, but instead it's just something that's part of the world. In a way, characters in movies are kind of like influencers we see on social media. Whether they're directly selling us a product or not, when a movie character does something, eats something, or wears something, we might be influenced just by the fact that we like them in the movie and are more inclined to get whatever product they might be using. So though product placement has seriously infiltrated our movies and TV shows, they're not so bad in the sense that they're ruining anything. In fact, they're doing the opposite. If product placement wasn't a thing, maybe we'd see a lot less movies and TV shows on our screens.